In this example, we are asked to construct a truth table for the given statement to determine whether the statement is a tautology, a self-contradiction, or neither. If you recall, a tautology will have all truths in the final column, a self-contradiction will have all falses in the final column, and then any other combination would be neither. We want to notice right away that this statement involves P, Q, and R, so it involves three statements, which means that our truth table will need eight rows. So let's review the standard setup for a P, Q, and R statement. So the standard setup is for under the P, you will do four truths, then four falses. For the Q, you will alternate every two. So two truths, two falses, two truths, and then two falses. And then for the R, you will alternate each time. So if you examine those rows, you will notice that every row has a different combination of truth values among the three statements. As we move to the other columns, we always want to keep our goal in mind, this conditional we have. And so we want to eventually have a column for the P if and only if R. We also want to have a column for not Q and not R. So the order you do your columns is not unique. It can be slightly different than the process used here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my next column to talk about some negations. So let me go ahead and do my negation of Q in the next column, not Q. It's just going to be the opposite of everything in the Q column. So Q's were two truths, two falses, and so on. So the not Q will be two falses, two truths, two falses, then two truths. Oops. You don't want to rush through these. Not R will be the opposite of the truth values in the R column. So that will be false, true, false, true, false, true, false, true. Those were the opposite of what was in the R column. And I'll return to those in a moment. Let's go ahead and create a column for this biconditional. Notice neither of those statements are negated. You're just doing P, if and only if, R, which means you are looking at the P column and the R column. If you recall, a biconditional is true if the truth values match, so either true and true, not and, but true if and only if true, false if and only if false, those are the scenarios where your biconditional come out true, where your truth values match. So if I'm looking at the P column and the R column, in the first row they match, so that's true. The second row they do not match, so that's false. The third row they match, so that's true. The fourth row they do not match, so that's false. Again, they do not match. Then they match, so this is a true. Then they do not match. And then they match. So biconditionals are true when the truth values match. So notice, again, that happened. Here they matched, then they were different, Then they matched. Then they were different. They were different again. Then they matched. Different and matching. You can see how detailed these need to be. Erase all that highlighting. Okay, now we can create a column for this conjunction, not Q and not R. Not Q and not R. So to create a truth column for not Q and not R, I'm looking at not Q column, which I created here, as well as the not R column. And it's a conjunction, meaning it's only true if both are true. So I can just look. That only occurs here in the fourth and then the last. Those are the only places where you have true and true, looking at those columns. So the rest of these are going to be false. And now we are able to get to our final statement because we have both parts. So notice I like to set it up where I'm not looking too far back to create my final column. It is a conditional in this direction with the if and only if statement first as the antecedent and then the conjunction there as the consequent. So we're looking in this direction. If you recall, a conditional is only false when you have a true antecedent and a false consequent, like in that first row. So this would be false. The second row is false implies false, that is true. Then we have true implies false, which is false. False implies true is true. Anytime you have a false as your antecedent, you're going to have a true conditional. True implies false is false. False implies false is true. True implies true is true. So we do not have all trues. We do not have all falses in that final column. So in this case, it is neither a tautology nor a self-contradiction.